Welcome again to another episode of Mandaway Beyond Borders. In Beyond Borders, we get to know the notable personalities who shaped DepEd Mandaue into a successful organization. Dire atong mailaila ang tao sa likod sa posisyon. And for today's episode, we will get up close and personal with the leader of our number one stakeholder, the parents of our learners. Our guest for today is the representative of our Parents Teachers Association to the Mandaue City Local School Board. Today, she will take our questions and challenges of Beyond Borders. Warm greetings to our chair and president of the Federated Parents Teachers Association of Mandaue City, Mrs. Dixie Ortiz. Mayong odto, Ma'am Dixie.
Mayong odto, Sir Bian. And good afternoon to each and everyone who are watching today.
Ma'am Dixie, can you share with us few information about you before getting married? Like your college life or even basic education life?
Okay. So before I got married, let me share first that I am a little bit sexier than today. So my college life, in profession, I am a teacher. And I graduated my baccalaureate degree in education sa Cebu Normal University. So I took BEd, Bachelor in Elementary Education, with a specialization of English. And I also took my 2 years academic course in my master's degree for English language teaching. Yes, and I'm proud to say that I am a product Serbian of the public school since I was in elementary until college.
Well, Ma'am Dixie, good to note that you are an educator also. So we are happy that you're leading the PTA, and at least we are quite sure that you know the plight of the educators because you are one of them.
Yes, I was once a teacher, a grade 1 advisor, way back 2007 to 2008.
I have heard that you have a lot of talents, but can you share some of your talents or what are those?
Oh, okay. Aside from eating, one of my talents is also singing.
Oh, wow.
And what are you sharing a song, sir?
I have heard also that you are good in, once you work with an FM. Right?
Before, during summer times in the past.
Sample punchline of a broadcaster?
It's not really broadcasting, but it's more of doing some DJs.
Sample?
Task. Maybe for W Rock. 96.3 W Rock, the heart of light rock. Or if you like, I can also do the Metro. Yeah, but so. I did not work in Metro. I just would love to, you know, do the punchline in Metro. Mm-hmm. Pero dili man siguro taana ma copyright nila, sir, no? Dili na lang na ako yung punchline ng Metro.
Kipasiga, mayan sila ga-promote kanila.
Yes, that is right.
But with your talent in music, Ma'am Dixie, rest assured nga, before we'll end our episode, we will give you time to showcase your singing talent.
So I'll become a recording artist after this.
For the meantime, we'll go with our topics or discussion, being part of giving quality basic education. But before that, we would like to know more of you as a parent.
Okay.
So, Ma'am Dixie, can you share with us pila man kabuk imong anak, pila ka lalaki, pila ka babae, asa sila nag-eskwela, niya, unsa may imong ikasulti, kumusta man sila sa ilang pag-eskwela?
So far, Sir Bian, nag-handig kong anak, no? I have 5 children, and 4 of them are boys. Hmm. O sara kabuok ang babae. And they are currently studying akong elementary. They are studying sa Subang Dako Elementary School. Mm. And ang akong high school, I have two in grade 10 and grade 8 na sa Subang Dako Technical Vocational School. So far karon they're doing well.
So silang lima ka eskwela na?
Ang usa padung.
Ah, so duha sa high school, duha po
duha sa elementary. And then come the next school year, ako sad i-enroll sa daycare sa Subang Dako ang ako ang fifth child. Oh, okay. 3 years old naman siya, and then he'd be coming 4 by May 11 next month.
Yeah, so far, unsa may imong kasulti sa ilang pag-eskwela?
So far, the first 3 quarters are really good. My children, most especially in the elementary, they are consistent achievers. So just about a week ago, or mga last Monday, man siguro to when we had our recognition in the elementary sa Subang Dako. And also karon recently they are doing online classes because of the suspension of the face to face tungod sa tumang kainit. And then also aside from online, they're doing modules this time.
As a mother having 4 children in school, can you share as unsa may challenges imong nagian, especially during the pandemic?
So very lisod jud kaayo, Sir Bian. Okay, during the pandemic, that was the time when wala na mi helper sa balay. And then I used to have my dad help na ko sa balay. But pag pandemic, since na may mga borders closed, and then my dad is from Cebu City, so dili na siya makalabang kay kanang senior. Kami na lang yun. So ang challenge there is how we are going to meet ends between work and then also the needs of my children sa school.
At then, kanang challenge nga imong nagian during the pandemic, have you experienced the same challenge now nga nag-distance learning tatungod apod sa higher heat index?
Slight, slight, Sir Bian. Because ang challenge mangod karon is while they're doing online class, okay ra, because they have their cell phones, we have computers at home, and internet. But in terms of doing the modules, kinahanglan gid siya tagaan og time. You cannot just have your children work on the modules without inspecting it. Kaya wala ta kabaloon sa ipang suwat nila din ha, if it's right or wrong. And then naapadyo'y trabaho, nag-demand og time. So mauna siya nga, ang paghatag og time sa module is really challenging for the parents who are working.
But assuming I have the authority to make policy. Ang policy is kanang mag-distance learning. Are you amenable? Nga, assuming lang ba nga I am a policy maker and I will issue policy nga mag-distance learning na from year day 1 up to the end of classes.
Dili jud ko muuyon ana, Sir Bian.
Ngano man unsa may makita nimong disadvantage ko?
Ang disadvantage na to, if it's always distance learning from the day 1 of classes until the end, is the learning gap. And we can see the effects of the pandemic. Grabe kayo ka behind ang ato ang mga students, most especially in terms of reading. And if we are going to do distance learning, dili tanan parents capable of homeschooling their children. Dili sa tanan parents aware on sao nila pag-treat ilang children when they introduce the lessons. All the more parents nga parihan ako challenge og like math, lisod gyud kaayo siya. So dili gyud ko amenable to having a distant learning since day 1 of classes until the end.
Although you are educator by profession, pero karon wala na nimo gi-practice. So during the pandemic, mo say amen ba ka sa observation na ang mga parents during that time nakita gin nila na ang unsa ka importante ang role sa teacher?
Exactly. I can really say that. Kay before mo ana ang uban kasagaran nga mga parents no mura nagbaliwala na malang ibilin lang pagkangan nga nakabilin sa ilang mga bata sa eskwelahan, okay na kayo among huna-huna. And then if there is something wrong, dali ra kaayo mi mutangkag among dunggan, musugod dayon mi sa eskwelahan. With ang some maybe mangaway pa siguro. But then pag pandemic, pag wala na face to face with the teacher, diha makita ra gina di ay nato hala di man di ay ni sayon. Kay kita gali kami gali mismo nakuan mi sa mong mga anak, naglagot mi, na-stress mi, kay usa, duha, tulo, rana. How much more our teachers usa in the classroom?
Class of 30 classy. To 50.
That's right. Mm-mm. So makita agyud sa pandemic, karon nga distant learning, makitaan agyud nga unsa ka-importante ang trabaho sa maestra. Dili lang na sila biyaanan sa mga anak, kay of course, dili na sila mga tigbantay, but also, they are the ones who are shaping their future. So muna na, karon makaingon jud ko, dili jud siya sa yun, oy.
As a mother, niya ikaw may mag-tutor kay karon apply na po lagi na to distance learning. O papilion ka, madam. Asa may imo, modular or online platform?
I would prefer the online platform. Because in the online platform, bisan pa siya o distant, but there is still touch base sa teacher. Like for example, in our case, sa elementary namo sa Subang Dako, ang math teachers kay they are really very religious. Our math teacher in grade 5 is very religious in doing online class. Kay mas lahi yun if si teacher ang mag-explain sa atong mga anak. And even though it's online, kay mga bata naanad naman sa online, kay mag-YouTube, kanang mga TikTok, kung kanang platform sa Google Meets, dili rasad na siya ingon nga kuan kayo, layo ra kayo sa mga bata karon.
So sa online or mo favor ka, pero mo pabor ba po ka kung dili purely lang gyud nga real time?
Yes.
So i-blend na to synchronous o asynchronous.
Correct. Pabor gihapon ko ana Sir Bian, for the reason that dili tanan nga mga ginikanan na ay cellphone ng mga bata, na ay computer, na ay internet. So if pwede pa lang siguro no tagaan na to og free nga internet o magagamit og cellphone or tablet sa mga bata from the government just like pandemic. Kung tanan kay dili bisag pandemic limited lang ang gitagaan og gadgets. So pwede gyud na siya. But karon since dili man gyud siya tanan, so uyon ra gyud ko nga blended lang siya ang atong module.
Well, I understand a while ago you made mention nga one of your challenges is how to balance your time with how you will tutor or guide your learners kay nag-distance learning. So, for me, my understanding is you are a working mother.
Yes.
So, okay lang ba kung mga tanamin nimo kung unsa ang imong trabaho ron? Asa or any information?
Sure. So, karon, this is my 16th year of Sykes Asia Incorporated. So, that is a BPO industry, which is now known as Found Ever Asia.
So, unsa may primary kuan kaniya kanang work ni mo diha?
Ang amo ang trabaho dira is business outsourcing. So, we work for companies outside.
Same ra na siya sa mga call center?
Yes, oo. Call center na siya, Sir Bian, and then we are working for companies outside.
So, no wonder day nga kanang mailagin ni mo the way you speak na fluent kayo ka sa English speaking. Kay almost every day you are dealing with online customers ng mga English.
That is right. So, sa trabaho, Sir Bian, I handle a team. I started as an agent.
For 16 years
agent.
Na?
Yes. And then I had my chances of growing with my career no as a language trainer. And then pag human sa language trainer, I went to product training kay mas murag duol-duol ko sa operations. But then murag sa training limited jud kayo ang time that I can go off kay magklase ka and then walay mapuli sa imong mga training. So I went and shifted to the operations.
Is it home base or you have the office too?
We have on-site. Before the pandemic, it's 100% on-site. Yeah, but during the pandemic, everyone is working from home.
And now?
And currently, we are doing the blended as well, hybrid work setup. So we have 2 days in the office and then the rest of the days working at home.
So meaning doon na po yung mga lessons learned gyud sa pandemic kay mga companies na wala mag-practice sa una karon mag-practice na nila.
Yes, that is right,
na home base.
Because dako jud kaayo siyag save sa employee. Kay mawagtang na dira imong pliti, imong kaon. Unlike kung moadto ka sa opisina.
You are a working mother. If you don't mind, are you willing also to share with us how about your husband? Sa po yung work?
Yes, we are working in the same industry sa Kumbana call center gihapon BPO, but
not
na
the same
sa lahing company. Yes. Before we used to work in the same company, but then ni-resign siya, nibalhin siya lain nga company. Kay I always believe nga mas better gyud nga lain-lain mi og company, kay if in the event na ay mahitabo sa company, at least na alang gyapoy nagtrabaho sa amoa. Kay lisod gyud nga walay usara ang magtrabaho, Sir Bian. So that is why kana muna amuhang technique sa akong husband nganong karon na ana siya sa lain na company.
Well, Madam Trixie, ang teachers na gitawag po lain-lain classes teachers. But as a parent also, can you share with us also for you what type of parents are you? Not only you but even your husband. Pareha ba mo na klase pagka parent or lain-lain mo?
Yes, for me and my husband, we are kind of parents na authoritative. So when we say authoritative, we nurture the needs of our children. We give them the needs. Mm. We protect them. And we also support them for what they want. Mm. But we set limits. We set boundaries. So we want to make it a point na our children will look at us with authority in the house.
Does it mean being authoritative that even especially your high school kids now being authoritative, does it mean nga you are telling them now when you will be in college, this should be your course and this will be your school? Does it mean for that?
It doesn't really apply for us to choose what is the college baccalaureate degree our children would get. Sa amua mong good Sir Bian, what I always normally do, huddles, mga meeting sessions with my children because I discuss rules again and again, like household chores. And then, kanang mga on me, hindi kagabi, that is the best time for me to always share to them unsa ako ang day, mangutana sa ilaha, how they their day went through. And then, usasad na sa among mahisgutan ang college, labi na ako'y grade 10. Para sa kuha, dili siya mo follow ang being authoritative in terms of really pushing a particular degree sa imuhang anak. Because sa akong case, I always want them to share with me on sa ilang gusto. And we support them.
As a mother, how do you, what you call this, make that arrangement to your children that each one of them has their own specific assignment to do every day at home?
Yes. Even now, that actually started a lighter task before the pandemic. But during the pandemic, since wala naman yun siya, Sir Bian, wala naman yun may helper, wala na ako ang parents na maka-help na mo, akong gitagaan og assigned task tanan from the youngest to the eldest. So ang pinakabugat nga trabaho o complicated nga trabaho adto sa maguwang tumanghod. So mo na karon if ever sa balay naay mga kinahanglan buhaton, mo ask dagad akong mga anak, unsa man ima, maguwang tumanghod or manghod to maguwang? Kaya I have set the rules man nga for example, if it's doing some task, it is maguwang tumanghod. But if it's something that is lighter or something like mukao na ta or muhatag og kanang something, it has to be manghud to maguwang. So inaanang ako ang pag-distribute sa task at home.
Well, it's a good practice, Ma'am Dixie, but wala ba ka po siya naka-result into kanang itawag nila ija-ija, aho-aho sa bulano term nga ngayon. Imo man ang task, imo rana. Kaya di apo kuya ako or willing silang mo help bisag dili ilang task.
Well, the trick there sa amo ang balay, Sir Bian, is though naa sila ilain-lain nga task, but the moment nga dili mahuman ang tanan, dili yun tanan makagunit og cellphone, makatanaw og TV. Kaya I always tell them nga kinahanglan mag pakwan pakol. The same sad og makasa. Kaya ako man ang kuan sa una sa dinalhan sa among parents na mo, akong isunod. So mo na nga for example na task ang maguwang nga manghugas sa plato magabii, and then napa siya'y manghud nga wala pa nakahugas og nakasud og tubig para sa ref. So ang maguwang magdali-dali sa manghud, sige na ikuha na para makuha na nako akong cellphone sa kwarto ni mama. Mo na nga bisan og lain-lain sila task, dapat mahuman jud mong tanan kahusa or else walay TV, wala tanan.
Pwede well, nagisgot kag pack one pack all. Now so maybe that is part of what we call as discipline.
Yes.
So, Can we know how do you discipline your kids?
Yes, in disciplining the children, we always start in setting the rules. Okay, without the rules, pataka lang na sila. And then we also set expectations nga dapat maoni, maoni ang kung for example dili na nimo ma-follow nga rule, maoni ang mahitabo. If maoni ang mahitabo, maoni siya ang mo domino effect sa mga ganahan nimong pangbuhaton nga mga leisure time, sa inyong leisure time, like sa inyong cellphone, sa computer, sa TV.
So what motivations or what particular awards nga inyong gihatag sa situation nga wala sila ni violate sa miyantag standards or set of policies nga inyong gihatag?
Sa amuang mga rewards sa mga bata, Sir Bian, like for example, ibutang nato sa eskwelahan, in a school week, sa usa ka week, sa usa ka weekday, og okay ra, wala problema sa balay, I always make it a point nga mag-prepare kog lami nga food during the weekends. Magluto-luto ko, hilig kong luto-luto, Sir Bian, muna makita siguro sa ako ang lawas. Or sa lawas akong mga anak nga wala dyan niwang kana. And then second na mo nga gi-out the reward sa ilaha is ang kanang ilang mga ganahan nga buhaton, like for example magbike. Kay dili man ko musugot nga magsigi og bike for safety purposes and for the reason that init kaayo karon. And then second kanang maggamit sa ilang phone kay mo jud na pirmi ilang leisure time nga buhaton. Og ang ikatulo magtanaw og TV. Muna yung mga rewards na
Madam Dixie is we always hear people saying lahi na gyud ang mga batan-on sa niaging panahon. Do you say the same kind of music or my main is pareha ba ka og sentimento sa uban nga mingon nga lahi na ang batan-on karon kaysa una?
Para nako, Sir Bian, I would not say it's different because in psychology masauna og makaron ang tanan nga mga humans are born in a mind with a clean slate. Sa ilang giingon pa, tabula rasa tang tanan. Ang nakadiferensya lang, it's how we are going to nurture the minds of our children, how we bring them up in the family, unsao nato sila pag-disiplina, o ang ilahang environment, mauragin na siyang nakalahi.
Yeah.
And the difference, mangod sa una, is we are now in the digital era. The social media played a very big role in our children and we cannot stop them from doing that because naaman sa mga maayo nga makatunan sa social media.
So siguro muna Madam Dixie nga kay na naman tas period na technology na gyud ang ato ang ginagamit muna ganyan nga siguro dili gyud siya safe ngayon ta nga lahi na the same mga gyapon mga batan-on but muna gyud ang nakalahi lang kay they are using now the technology. So,
correct.
Ana na ang bugat kaya ang role sa parents.
Exactly. Diha ang role gyud sa parent, the parenting style, the parenting scheme. Kay parihara man gyud, wala man dyan nausab sa mga sa pagkatao unless siguro og naay mga degenerative nga mga changes sa DNA.
Yes.
Muna mausab ang mga bata sa unang panahon og sa karon. Kay ang nausab karon is not really the kids but how we bring them up. Kay for sure if napatay mga parents karon who will bring up their children the way we used to have in the past, parihara gyapon na kay ang bata dili man na magkuan if ever dili gyud na siya nimo i-expose og media. Parihara gyapon siya sa una if ever ingana ang pag-bring up sa parents.
Well, with that can you share with our parents viewing with us what life lesson you have as a parent that you can share them? Perhaps they can use it as guide nga ani diay as a parent mo ni lesson nga akong nakuha.
Yes, the life lesson I got no as a parent and I have always been sharing this to my children as well is to always be kind than to be right. Kaya kita nga mga parents, we have the tendency sa ato mga children nga kita pirmi ang sakto. But then, without knowing, ang kanang pag-impose na to, kung unsay pirmi sakto sa atong mga anak, it may break them. Or sometimes, it may make them. And sadly, the greatest part of breaking a child is when they are being rejected by their parents. So even if parents, we know that we are right, at least when we say something to our children, we have to do that with kindness. After all, dili man na sila nato mga enemies nga pirmi na tong syagitan. They are our children. They are coming from us. So I always want everyone, as much as possible, when there are things that we have to do with our children, it has to have, you know, kindness. I know nga kinahanglan magita mo disiplina, but lahi masalang disiplina but from being a terror. So at least let us be kind to our children.
Well, Madam Dixie, it has been a good talk with you. We learn a lot from you as a parent, how to discipline. Munay yon nga as educator mangi ka. For me, murag pwede na kang mo join sa DepEd because you have the quality, no? If you will be with us as educator, munay yon ba nga you are one of those nga who can implement that what they call kanang positive discipline,
yeah.
No? And okay, usually mo muna ang issue nga how to apply that what you call positive discipline.
Yeah, exactly. Okay.
So we learn a lot about Ma'am Dixie as a parent. So for now, let's pause a break. And when we come back, we will enjoy more conversations from our president of the Federated Parent Teachers Association of Mandaue City.
Whisper Challenge. Player 1 wears a headphone with a loud music playing on it. Player 2 whispers words to Player 1, which Player 1 must guess by lip reading. Let the games begin.
Computer. Reading. Clinic. Bill? Balik, sir. Building. Yeah. Balik, sir. Yeah. Building.
Milk.
Dili ko.
Milk.
Secretary. Security. Security? Ah, security guard. Oh, okay. Balik, sir. Gulayan.
Principal.
Balik, sir. Principal. Teacher.
Okay.
Okay.
And we're back.
Welcome back to Beyond Borders. We are still with Ma'am Dixie Ortez, our Federated PTA President. Ma'am Dixie, kumusta man so far ang imuhang experience as Federated PTA President?
Yes, so far, Sir Beyond, it's really a very challenging position.
Do you think it's satisfying on your part?
Yes, really, really satisfying. Dako gyud siya nga satisfaction for me when I can see nga naay daghan nga mga na happy sa ako ang mga nabuhat nga pagtabang sa ilaha.
How many years naman kang president sa federation?
So far, this is my second year as the president and this is my fourth year in the federation.
So before na president ka, what other positions you have?
Yeah, I started as the secretary sa FPTA and then the following year I became the vice president. And then after being the vice president, nag-president na dayon ko twice.
Wala ba ni mo makita nga ang imong pagka-official, especially president sa federation, naka-hustle sa imong obligation as a parent and at the same time as a company personnel or worker?
Well, so far for me, it's not really a hustle. Wala gid siya. I know it's a very challenging and very busy task.
Yes,
and I could ask myself, why am I doing this when akong makaprovide mong ko sa akong children. But I am think ang akong gihunahuna mong God is not just my children alone, but ang tibuok ng mga children nga nag-eskwela sa Mandawi, sa public school. And at the same time, I'm also looking at parents. Unsa man to akong mga parents ng mga kailang, mga amiga nga, they cannot speak themselves. They don't have the courage to do what they have to do to help their children. So Mona, I am looking at this as something, this is a challenge, this is a passion, but not more of a hustle for me. Because I always believe nga in life, our goal is to always make ourselves happy. But it's even better if we make someone happy.
Well, good for you, Ma'am Dixie, that you said it's not a hustle on your part. But reality-wise, in our schools, I experienced for 8 years classroom teacher man ko, many of our parents declined to become officers.
Correct.
Ngano man ka, Ma'am Dixie?
Very demanding sa time, Sir Bian, kung ma-officer ka. And aside from very demanding sa time, bisag nagbutang na kasi imuhang tanan nga effort, dili man tanan makauyon. Dili sad tanan maka-appreciate. And then most of the time, naadyo yung mga bashing nga mahitabo. So muna nga, para sa uban nga mga parents, I would say nga, dili sila ganahan mag-officer, kay puno-puno lang na sa ilang trabahoon. And at the same time, unsa may makuha na ko as a person, labi na wala bi anay sweldo libre diha na. Unya nag-demand pag gidog time on saon man ako na lang ihatag sa akong mga anak, ako na lang ning ihatag sa akong trabaho. Muna nga ang rason, lisod jud kayo if manay ma officer. My God, baliba dayon, dili gyud ko ana ang uban dili mo attend sa PTA meeting para dili ma-elect.
Unya Ma'am Dixie, sure man gyud ko nga daghan kayo rong mga parents nga pareha nimo qualification unta nga ayan officers pero mo decline lagi. So unsa may kay imong ika advice nila aron di na sila mo decline?
So ako ang ika advice kay ang atong hunahunaon lang no is not really ang ato ang kaugalingon.
Yes.
But we have to think of what we can do good for everyone, most especially ang ato ang mga bata sa Mandawi City.
Well, thank you for that advice and I hope na sa next school year, Ma'am Dixie, makita na nato ning uban lagi nga.
Lagi.
Ibalibad.
Oo.
Di na mabalibad.
Kay last term na nako karon Sir Bian, as the president, kay sa officership, we only have 2 years.
Sa federation?
Oo, sa federation.
As per the PID policy.
Yes, that is right. So, I am encouraging the parents who are more capable to join the federation. Kay daghan kaayo ang nanginahanglan sa atoa, but few are chosen to be part of the officers. So please, join kita. If
2 years per policy as president. Pero mo na, nga nag-encourage kita kay daghan man. As we notice, daghan kayong mga
daghan
angayan. Pero mo lagi na, nga dili lang willing.
Oh, ang willingness lang and also ang paghatag og time. Kay ang time jud mo ay pinaka-demanding and diha gyud kasagaran ang fallback sa atong mga parents nga mahimong mag-officer sa federation.
Well, another thing, Ma'am Dixie, is supposedly teachers and the parents should collaborate.
Right.
Now, can you tell us nga collaboration is really present and successful only in your school but as per feedback from other federation officials?
Yeah, so far I can really see the collaboration between the parents and the teachers based on the feedback sa different nga mga officers that we have in the federation. And also, the parents nga ako ang mga amiga o amigo sa mga eskwelahan nga nagtungha akong mga anak. Kaya usually, in the federation meeting, naagyod mi round table nga mahitabo after the meeting. And in that round table, we are going to ask what are your feedback, concerns, or any comments regarding how the PTA relationship works in the school. And then, di mo sad tamag, I don't wanna be a hypocrite, naagyo yung mga times nga naadyo yung misunderstanding. But I am happy nga mapangitaan gud siya og way nga ma-resolve kung naamanggali misunderstanding mahitabo between, the relationship between the teacher and the parents.
Okay. So, good to know that, Ma'am Dixie.
Yes.
Okay. Then, I understand also that you are an officer not only in one school but in 2 schools.
Yes, that is right.
So, in Subanda ko, elementary school, you are?
The president.
Federation president sa school.
Yes.
How about Bandako Tekbog?
President gihapon.
So 3-in-1 din eron.
Yes, and
president,
I'm also
Subang Dakot English School.
Yes.
President of Subang Dakot Tekbok and Division Federated.
Correct. And then I'm also the president sa Subang Dakot Football Club.
So imagine sa DepEd alone tulo ka organization ang muiban sa imong time.
Yes.
Because you have to have meetings also with your
correct.
Subang Dakot LM.
Tinood
na. Subang Dakot Tekbok na plus the federation.
Correct. Tinood gyud na siya.
But still looking at you, wala may musita, wala yung mga marka nga stress ka.
No? Wala sa koy absent.
Career
gyud. Ala siguro gamay.
Career gyud always and even sa atong local school board meeting, more 100% attendance gyud.
Yes.
No? So, nganaano gyud nga kanang mayor sa time management.
Yes. Basta i-manage lang gid nato ang time and then ako I always prioritize aside from my children also my work kay unsaon man ako pagbuhi sa akong mga anak ug walay trabaho. So if ever naay mga schedule nga meetings, I always ask help sa akong manager, sa akong mga agents para makahatag sad kog time kay dili ko ganahan nga nagpapili gani ta as a president noon niya ang ending dili din nato atinan ang mga meetings. So murag it's a shame on me nga wala ko ni balibad sa position, but then if when we go to the action, it's always absent. So mo na akong gibarugan ang akong pagka-officer sa tanan nga organizations nga akong ingi-involve by not neglecting them and by managing my time.
Nagisgot kag football club, is it connected with DepEd or it's a private organization?
It's a private organization, but our children kay mga kuan mga nasa public schools.
Ah.
We also have mga integrated nga mga private schools who joined our club in Subang Dako. Kay that is for the whole barangay man. And then not all
so,
the children.
Mayo di ka mudo arog football.
Dili kayo. Come on, mo patid. But not really that much.
I stand connected ganina niyan ko tulo ka positions. Para nakukita-kwinta na ko ron, lima di ay. Kay before ka nahi mong school federation, school or tawag na sa school level, school PTA, nahi mo gikang president po sa classroom.
Yes,
niya,
president.
Sa Subang Dako, Tekbok mo po. So lima di ay, dili tulo. So I stand corrected.
Wow.
So lima ka mga meetings nga imong pag-atinan kay patawag kag meeting, mag-meeting mo sa classroom, mag-meeting sa school, mag-usapay ka sa school.
Oo. And also, sa ako asan nga kay Serbian, dili ko type nga leader nga ako huntanan. I always, aside from managing my time, I always manage my task sa mga constituents nako. Just like how I bring up my children nga tagaan ako og task, sa organization sad, ang mga co-officers nako pang tagaan sad nako sila og task. Kay kung for example, og ako chug hunahunaon no nga kana tanan og magdungan man daay nag activity and all murag dili gyud na siya physically mabuhat nato. So it's also one way of helping me out is knowing how to manage my people.
Niya ma'am, 8 years manggit ko nga classroom teacher na 6 years as principal. Honesty aside, ang murag usual gyud nga expectation ini create the PTA is nga maka-create og project.
Correct.
Diba? Expect na yun ang maestra na yung project. So, can you share with us on say, mga projects ninyo sa LM o dito po sa PECAS?
Yeah, so far, sa dili sa panghambog, but being the president of both elementary and high school in Subang Dako, naagi yung mga projects. And I am happy, I am also happy and very proud to share nga, even the pandemic, nakapataod mi og CCTV cameras. Both elementary and in high school. Because I would always, kuan manggod nga, ang paglihok sa mga project, dili lang na siya angay buhaton sa presidente. Dili lang na siya angay huna-hunaon, pilion sa presidente. I always involve the officers, the parents in the decision making of unsa ang amuang mga project na i-come up para in the event na we will be working on it, dili na lang akua ang kaskas, akua ang sayaw. Involve sa mga parents. Kaya nga naman, when I make the decision, when I choose the project, it was them who built that decision with me. So, dili na siya ingana.
Of all those projects, unsa man ka ang pinaka, mayon ka bugat, pinakadako o gasto nga project nga inyong na-implement?
So far this year, ang pinakadako nga project na mo sa elementary is ang kani among guardhouse. Kaya nagpatukod mi og bag-o nga guardhouse sa elementary. And then ang kaning guardhouse, di lang sa din siya basta-basta nga imong gitukod nga na it's concrete.
Yeah. Kaya nakakita ko dito.
Oh. Because ang amo man na siyang gibutangan sad og expensive ang guardhouse because gibutangan na mo og CCTV monitor para sa mga bata. And then also soon butangan na mo paging system para sa mga mama nga magbilin og baon og something. And sa high school so far, ang pinakadako nga project nga amo ang gibuhat karon is ang pag procure og sewing machines para sa amo ang mga senior high school students.
Katong na sa Janela dressmaking.
Oh, sa dressmaking. Kay mo amo gid na siya problema karon Sir Bian. Kay ngano man ang amo ang stage amo na ang giproject sa una. But tungod sa dako-dako gid siya nga gastuhon with the help of Kimwa, almost sila naman jud tanan dito so ilahan na lang to namo gipaangkon ang stage. Murag happy sad mi sa.
But of course through the efforts of the PTA.
Yes, and also the school, the barangay who help us out and our principal. Kay ang amuasang mga immersion nga mga students dito mampud sa Kimwa. Partner man gid namo always ang Kimwa sa STVS.
Now, kaning magisgot kita projects pambiksi. Ang number one, I'm sure nga number one partner gyud sa project kanang making is ang source of funding.
Correct.
Igsoon man na sila. Ang ako po tanan nimo is, have you experienced nga during meetings kay mag-meeting mo para mag-isgot og project nga naay mga parents nga mutunga inighapit na mahuman kay ngana nga di sa tamutungag sayo kay mag-isgot na po itong projects?
Correct. Naagin na siya, Sir Bian. Dili dyan na siya makaingon nga. Di na makaingon nga wa na siya. Di gyud na siya mawala. And then, ano pa yung uban? Pagkapin, istorya, no? Pero that's okay. That's fine. Because I always believe nga, kita nga, kami nga mga parents, lahi may og level of understanding based on exposure that we have in the community and in the school. So muna, I always will not take that negatively. Kaya you're entitled to that. Balit lagi na siya.
All of us are aware man on sa gyud nganong na IPTA, but mo lagi na. Di gyud na mawa. One of the rules of IPTA is ang fundraising and to have projects.
Yes.
Now, as you have mentioned a while ago, mo-end ang imong term this year.
Yes,
If I may ask you, what legacy you would like to leave to the Federation as the president?
Yeah, the legacy that I would like to leave in the Federation is to always choose to be the solution, not the problem. Kaya kahibalo magita nga, kung maghisgot tayo ta og mga parents, naaman dyan mga parents nga, dili mo uyon, magka-cause og trouble sa eskulahan. But at the end of the day, we are working not for our teachers, for the school, but para ni sa atong gitan-aw, gilantaw diri isang atong ang mga anak. Kung unsa man gari na mga desisyon gibuhat sa eskulahan, sa PTA officers, dili na siya para sa mga mama ug mga papa ug mga student ang mga teachers, but para sa ato ang mga anak. So, I always would want everyone as my legacy to always think and always bear in mind that we should have to be the solution, not the problem.
So, Ma'am Dixie, with your presence today in our discussion with Beyond Borders, we are looking forward that our viewers, our parents will emulate and will follow suit what you are doing. And we are looking forward na all our parents will be like you nga who are very responsive to the needs of the schools. Nga despite your being a working mother, but still you manage to attend to the different groups, no? The school, the classroom PTA, the school PTA, the division federation, and even the local school board. Kay you are always present during our meeting. Yeah, monthly bi na itong local scoreboard. So, makayon kita ba nga your dedication to really serve DepEd through the PTA is beyond question. Okay, ana man makita sa attendance daan. Makita nato gid ang how sincere you are in serving the PTA. Now, we have been discussing a lot as a mother and as an officer, but before kanamo buhian, we will have that what we call pass talk.
Oh, okay.
Kung naay kita,
kuya, wala masagawa ni Sir Bian. Uy,
wala sa pass talk nila nga to. Pass talk. No? So sige. Just like that popular Q&A that we can view in the television, we will give you choices, or you have to choose between two things.
Okay.
And all you have to do is just choose one, but you cannot explain.
Oh, just choose okay. One. Nga naman.
No need to explain. Just choose one, two things that in every situation.
Okay.
Then choose one. And after that, after this pass talk, as promised a while ago, we had to listen to your angelic voice.
Sige.
Akapila lang siguro, no? Okay, wa man mikaride sa music. Ang among order nga kanang kwan sa to, kanang sound system for the music, wa pa maabot.
Ah, okay.
Are you ready, Ma'am Dixie?
Sige, I'm ready.
Okay. LSB or Federation PTA?
LSB.
Mama or Papa?
Mama.
Brigada Eskwela or School Feeding?
Brigada Eskwela.
Can read or can write?
Can read.
Zumba or fun run?
Zumba.
Beko or MCWD?
Oh my God! Beko.
Radio or TV?
Radio.
Credit card or cash?
Cash.
Science or arts?
Science.
Sweet or salty?
Sweet.
Roller coaster or Ferris wheel?
Ferris wheel.
Island hopping or road trip?
Island hopping.
Eyebrow or lipstick?
Eyebrow.
Dagat or swimming pool?
Dagat.
Mata og sayo or matulog og dugay?
My God! Matulog og dugay.
Sayaw or kanta?
Ari ko sa kanta.
Ah, okay. Manilhig or manlampaso?
Manglaba lang. I don't like both.
Manlaba or mamalansa?
Manglaba.
Manlaba. Tubig bugnaw o tubig init?
Bugnaw.
Too or wala?
Too.
Thank you. That's it, Ma'am Dixie.
Okay.
We have finally finished our pass talk. And
right.
With that, thank you again for being a good sport. Salamat sad sa imuhang time, and thank you also to our viewers watching our episode. I hope you get something to learn from our guest today, our very own president of the Federated PTA of DepEd Mandaue. So, Ma'am Dixie, do you have any final message to our friends watching this episode?
Well, my final message is to support our children in their blended learning modality. Kung pwede, labangan sa modules, but dili ansiran ang module. Kana lang yun, for now, sa ato ang bag-o karon nga pinaka-hot topic or hot issue. Tadluan sa module, but dili kita ang mag-answer sa module. Kana lang.
Great parting statement, Ma'am Dixie. But to become more greater, we would like to hear from you your angelic voice.
Unsa man akong kantahon? Sige, ang akong kantahon is for everyone. Most especially sa ato ang kung ano pag work on sa ato mga challenges together as a community.
Unsa may imong pilion, chorus lang or the whole music?
Chorus lang siguro. Akong mahuna-hunaan nga song is If We Hold On Together by Diana Ross. So, karaan na siya nga song, Sir Biano.
Okay.
Okay, so far, I like the musics in the past. Then, karon. Though na ako yung mga favorites sa mga bag-o, but mas nikuan sa ko ang mga karaan nga kanta.
Okay.
So, unsa man ato ang kuan? If we hold on together, I know our dreams will never die. Dreams see us through to forever. river where clouds roll by. For you and I.
So this has been Beyond Borders and Mandawi. Kaysa Mandawi, daghang pamaagi.
Na ika'y dumaan, sana'y maisa ng aking pangungulila. Trapped in this fairy tale, but I don't wanna wake up in this dream. Baby, ayoko umasa sa paniniwala. May pag-asa nga ba na baka ang puso ko'y mapagbigay?